Hi everybody, hope you are all fine. This is Atiq. I once again welcome all of you to our YouTube channel Engineering Drive. Dear students, let us now discuss one important type of trees, which is AVL tree. So what are AVL trees and how the AVL trees are constructed and what is the property they will follow? Each and everything I am going to discuss in my today's session. So dear students, first of all, AVL trees are height balancing binary search tree. So these trees are first of all height balancing binary search tree. So they are one category of binary search tree. Okay, now we know the condition of binary search tree. What is the condition binary search tree? The value of left child must be smaller than the parent, the value of right child must be greater than the parent. So but one new thing that comes in AVL trees are they are height balancing. So what is height balancing, we will come to know next. And the next point, why this name AVL has been given? So this AVL tree, the name is given based on their inventor Adelson, Welsky and Landis. So based on these three developers, the name has been given AVL. Okay, AVL tree. Okay, next point, AVL tree checks the height of left and right subtrees and assures that the difference is not more than one. So difference is not more than one means the difference can be 0 or 1. It should not be more than 1. That we need to take care. That is very, very important point. Okay. And next thing, this difference is called the balance factor. Now our entire understanding of AVL tree depends on this word. Which word? You know, balance factor. Okay, what is balance factor? Height of the left subtree minus height of the right subtree. Once you will calculate this difference, you will get the balance factor, and that balance factor can be 0 or 1, but it should not exceed 1. Okay, how we can do that? Let me explain next. Okay, so let me erase this. Okay, next point, what is balance factor? Let us take one example. Let us take, this is an AVL tree, okay, which consists of three nodes, node A, node B and node C. Now I want to know whether it is an AVL tree or not. Yes, I have taken it as it is an example of AVL tree. Let me assure that whether it is an AVL tree or not. Let me confirm it. How I can confirm? I need to calculate the balance factor at every node. How to calculate balance factor? You know, height of, suppose if I want to calculate balance factor of this node A, how to calculate the balance factor? Height of left subtree, this is left subtree, minus height of right subtree. In left subtree, what is the height we can take? 1. Okay, so here we can take the height as 1, and what is the height of right subtree? 1, because no other nodes are there here. And what is the, okay, this is height of left subtree and this is height of right subtree, and what is the height of this node A? It is 2, because two nodes are there here, height is 2. Now height of left subtree is 1, height of right subtree is 1. Now what is the balance factor of A? I want to find out. Balance factor formula is height of left subtree minus height of right subtree, which means 1 minus 1 is equal to, I got 0. Balance factor, I got 0. Similarly, what is the balance factor of node B? We don't have any left subtree and right subtree, which means 0. So 0 minus 0, 0. And here also 0 minus 0, 0. So what balance factor we got? Here we got balance factor 0, 0 and 0, which means it is an AVL tree. Because why we can say it is an AVL tree? We got balance factor value as 0. So if balance factor is 0 or either 1 also, it is an AVL tree. Okay, let us take one more example. Okay, this is an example here. Here I am showing you the difference between what is balanced and not balanced. Balanced tree is nothing but here it is an AVL tree. This is not balanced. Now how it became not balanced, we can see here the height we have calculated here. Okay, and once we know the height, then we can calculate the balance factor here. So here we got the balance factor of this node A as 0, because no left right subtree is there. 0 minus 0, 0. Here height of left subtree 1. So 1 minus 0. So let me write that also. This is 0 minus. Let me write this. Okay. 0 minus 0. Here 1 minus height of left subtree. What is height of left subtree? 1. 1 minus height of right subtree, 0. So 1 only. Here also 2 minus 0, 2. Because we don't have any right subtrees, that's why we'll get zeros only here. Okay, why we are saying this tree is not balanced? Because we can see here 2 minus 0 means we got balance factor. We got the balance factor. How much we got balance factor? We got balance factor as 2. If we get the balance factor as 2, then the tree is said to be unbalanced or not balanced. Same case we got here also. Negative values we should not consider. Even we got minus 2, minus 1, 0, we should take it as 2 and 1 only. So whenever we get balance factor more than 1, the tree will become unbalanced or not balanced. So this is an example of balanced and not balanced aviary trees. Now let us clearly understand how to calculate the balance factor as well as the height now. Okay, and which formula we need to use to do that work? Okay, I have given this explanation. Balance factor is equal to height of left subtree minus height of right subtree. Okay, now if the difference in the height of left and right subtrees is more than 1, which means if the balance factor is more than 1, the tree is balanced using some rotation techniques. Okay, let us, sir, okay sir, if the tree is balanced, no problem. What to do if the tree is unbalanced? So we need to use some rotation techniques that I will discuss in my next video. Now before that, let me take one more example. Okay, now let us take here, it will be here we can clearly understand how this aviary tree mechanism works. Now we have taken two colors here. Green means height and blue means balance factor. Now all of you, first of all, how many levels are there in this tree? You check. This is an aviary tree. In aviary tree is a type of binary search tree, which means 25 is less than 50, 75 is greater than 50, 60 is less than 75, 120 is greater than 75. So of course, if aviary tree is a type of binary search tree, so it should follow the binary search tree condition. That is clear. So blue indicates the balance factor, green indicates the height. Empty tree will have height 0, which means if no nodes are there in the tree, then that what is the height of the tree? We can say 0. Now how many levels are there in this aviary tree? This is level 1, level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, which means 4 levels are there in this tree. So the height of the 0 level, 1 level, 2, 3, 4. 0 to 4 means what is the height of this tree? How many levels are there? 5 levels. So that's why we have written the root node value height as 5. 5 levels are there. Okay, maximum last leaf node, up to the last leaf node we need to see. Next, what is the height of this left child? 25. Okay, so you need to see this side. Okay, this subtree. 1, 2, 3. So the height is 3. Similarly, let us take 75 now. So what is the height of 75? See the levels. From you need to count 75 also. 75, 120, 90, and this 8300, which means 4 levels. So the height is 4. So like this we need to calculate. Even the last leaf nodes will have height 1. 83, 1, 100, 1, 125, 1, 68, 1, 35, 1, and 10 also 1 height. Okay, because they are the last leaf nodes. Now how to calculate balance factor? Let me show you how to calculate balance factor of root node 50. So height of left subtree, what is the height of left subtree? 3 minus height of right subtree. What is the height of right subtree? 4. So 3 minus 4 minus 1. Okay, let us calculate the balance factor of this right child 75 now. So we got minus 1. How we got minus 1? Height of left subtree. This left subtree we need to include. So what is the height of left subtree? 2. 2 minus height of right subtree minus 3. 2 minus 3 minus 1 is the balance factor. Okay, similarly I want to calculate the balance factor of, let us say, 120. So how to calculate the balance factor of 120? Height of left subtree, which is 2 minus height of right subtree. What is the height? 1. 2 minus 1? 1. So like in this way, we need to calculate the balance factor. Now, after once we have calculated the balance factor, we need to check out whether we got any value which is exceeding 1. Exceeding 1 means whether we got balance factor as 2, 3, 4 and so on, means greater than 1. So we didn't got anywhere greater than 1 balance factor, which means this AVL tree, this tree is a perfect AVL tree. Why I am saying it is a AVL tree? Because there is no, what is the balance factor value we got? Either we got 0 or either we got 1 or either we got minus 1. It is acceptable, but it should not cross 1. It should not exceed 1. If we get the balance factor 2, then the tree is said to be unbalanced. Now the question is, if the tree is unbalanced, what to do, sir? If once the tree is unbalanced, we can make it balanced by using some rotation techniques. We call the concept as AVL rotations. So dear students, in my next video, I am going to discuss about how an unbalanced AVL tree can be converted into a balanced AVL tree. Yes, of course, an unbalanced AVL tree, we should not use the word AVL tree for that. Anyhow, if it is unbalanced, how we can convert it to a balanced AVL tree? That I am going to explain in my next video. So with this, let me close my today's session. See you soon, everybody. Take care. Love.